Dear students, welcome back to my YouTube channel MCV ChemTube. This is an online chemistry tutorial. So you get my previous videos from my website or from my YouTube channel. So in last two lectures we were discussing about the topic halogen compound that comes under the organic chemistry, and in this video I'm going to discuss with you reactions of halogen compound, that is nucleophilic substitution reaction, SN1 and SN2 reaction as mechanism and energy profile diagram. So this is a simple scheme of nucleophilic substitution reaction, and in nucleophilic substitution reaction is the most important reaction of haloalkane. And this nucleophilic substitution usually you can make a wide variety of functional group out of haloalkane by using this simple method. And what is nucleophilic substitution? It is a reaction in which a nucleophile replaces leaving group. That is called nucleophilic substitution. So in this reaction, you can see here in this example, a substrate of carbon undergo heterolytic bond fission here, this one. Then unshared pair of electron from nucleophile form a new bond with carbon. So nucleophile is a Lewis base, and this alkyl halide can act as an electrophile, that is Lewis acid. And this is an examples of nucleophilic substitution. You can see here the various functional group can be created out of alkyl halide. So you can make if you are using nucleophile hydroxyl group, you can make ethanol. Similarly, you can make number of compounds as shown in this table. So what are the mechanism of nucleophilic substitution reactions? On the basis of experimental observation over a period of 70 years, two limiting mechanisms proposed for aliphatic nucleophilic substitution, SN1 and SN2. SN1 substitution nucleophilic unimolecular, and SN2 substitution nucleophilic bimolecular. So what is the fundamental difference between SN1 and SN2? That is only the time of bond breaking between carbon and leaving group, and the time of bond forming between carbon and nucleophile. So there are some differences like this. So let us discuss SN2 substitution nucleophilic bimolecular reaction. This is an example for SN2 reaction of methyl halide chloride with the nucleophile, strong nucleophile, it gives methanol. And it was found that the chemical kinetic studies reveal that the rate of the reaction depends on both the concentration of chloromethane, that is substrate, and hydroxide, that is nucleophile. So rate depends on both substrate and nucleophile, so it is called bimolecular reaction. So rate equation is like this, and this is a secondary reaction, and it is bimolecular reaction. So what is the mechanism then? And this is the mechanism of SN2 reaction, and in this reaction it is a single step mechanism process involved through a transition state. There is no intermediate here, and bond breaking and bond formation take place simultaneously. That is a concerted process. So it occurs simultaneously. You can see that this hydroxyl group react with the nucleophile, react with the carbon, this electrophile, and it form a transition state like this, and finally you get a product. And here you have to understand something. This hydroxyl group is attacking from the back side, so it cannot approach from the front side. Why? Because bromine is electronegative, so this is also electronegative, it can repel. So it only, there is chance or room for backside attack. And it form a transition state, and In transition state, you can see some features. This all three hydrogens are in same plane. This is in same plane. And this is, you know, pentad coordinated. That is, there is no bond formation here. At the same time, the CBR bond, that is leaving group bond, is not broken completely. So these are the features in transition state. Okay, because of this backside attack, usually an inversion of configuration occurs. This is an orbital diagram of this nucleophilic substitution reaction. This is the, you know, highest occupied molecular orbital of nucleophile, and this is the LUMO of electrophile. This is antibonding orbital, this is bonding orbital. Okay, so nucleophile approaches the antibonding orbital and it started to bond. You know, you can see here this become bonding orbital. Okay, then leaving group, you know, take off from that. So HOMO of nucleophile begin to interact with the LUMO of carbon bearing leaving group. As reaction progress, nucleophile carbon strengthen and carbon leaving group bond weaken. Okay, so because of this backside attack, usually nucleophilic carbon bond forms, and this carbon can undergo an inversion of configuration. It is exactly like a turn inside out. So what does it mean? So you can more clear get that picture out of this diagram. So nucleophile is approaching and transition state is formed and product is obtained. So here you can represent this diagram as like this. I have shown an umbrella like structure like this. On nucleophile is approaching from this side. So this part become turned inside out like this. Like an umbrella in strong wind sometimes turn inside out. So such inversion was observed by Walden and scientists. So such inversions are called Walden inversion. Okay, like this. So next one, energy profile diagram of this SN2 reaction. So this is our study material substrate. The energy of substrate is here. So this is the energy of product alcohol. You can see that is an exothermic reaction. Energy of reactant is more than product. And here there is only transition state. There is no intermediate. And this transition state will be having higher energy because it involves 5 coordinated carbon atom with partial bond, and these are, you know, negatively charged. This will be having higher energy. So this is the simplest diagram of SN2 reaction. So here you can see the electrostatic potential diagram. Only I want to show that this one, this red part, usually electron density will be high. So it will attack this low dense area, that is blue area. This is the red one because it is a, it contains leaving group. So you can see in transition state, both are red here like this, negatively charged. And this is the product and this is the leaving group. So in transition state, you can see the red color is delocalized over nucleophile and leaving group. This is an example for a SN2 reaction. 1 bromobutane with sodium methoxide, it gave 1 methoxybutane. Here you can see that nucleophile approaching this electrophile and it form a transition state like this. And one important point here you are to understand is here the inversion of configuration occurs here. It's a Walden inversion. So this is attacking from this backside and this part get inverted and it form a product like this. Okay. So next one, SN1 reaction, substitution nucleophilic unimolecular reaction. Example is, when you react tertiary butyl halide with methanol, you get actually methyl tertiary butyl ether, methoxy tertiary butyl ether, alkane. So this is a solvolysis reaction, does not undergo through SN2 mechanism because here the backside attack is not possible because this tertiary butyl halide is hindered. It hindered the approach of nucleophile. So also the SN2 reaction, it require very strong nucleophile, but this is weak nucleophile. But at the same time, the reaction, we are getting product with very good yield and very fast. So it occurs in different mechanism, and it was found that the rate of reaction only depends on the substrate, does not depend on nucleophile. So it is an unimolecular reaction and first order reaction, and it is called unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. So what is the mechanism of SN1? It is a two-step process. It involves through an intermediate, and in first step what happens is ionization of carbon leaving group to form a carbocation. Why it is happening? When you have a tertiary group here, CBr bond can be slowly ionized. Why? Because this CBr bond is polarized, and after the ionization it is forming very highly stable product. That is the reason for this slow ionization. So it forms an intermediate like this. Shape is trigonal planar, and in next step nucleophile attack take place on electrophile. Actually two type of attack is possible here. It has an equal probability of attack from the back side from here, and it form, you know, if you attack, nucleophile is attacking from the back side, you get an oxonium with the inverted configuration. At the same time, like this, at the same time, this can, you know, the nucleophile can attach from the front side, so it can retain the configuration. So in this reaction, in second step, this finally get deprotonated, this oxonium, and it form a product like this. And in this reaction you can see that this is the intermediate. There is an equal probability of attacking from the back side and from the front side. If it is attacking from the front side, you get the same configurated product. If it is attacking from the back side, the opposite configuration. So here you will be getting a racemized product. That is more clear from this example. If you are reacting 3-bromo-3-methylhexane, it's an optically active compound. So you get 50% S form, this one, 50% S 3-methyl-3-hexanol. And at the same time, 50% R configurated product also. So the mixture will be optically inactive. This will be optically active, this also will be optically active, but mixture will be optically inactive. So this is the reason, you know, this is the intermediate, this all this carbon will be in same plane. So there is a possibility of tag from the top or tag from the bottom. So if it is, you know, you get a retention configuration in some cases, the inverted configuration in some other cases. Okay, that is the stereo chemistry of SN1 reaction. Next one, energy profile diagram. In energy profile diagram, you can see there are two intermediate we have seen in the mechanism, and one is the main intermediate, that is carbocation, and another intermediate is oxonium ion. And here, this is the study material, our study material, tertiary alkyl halide and methanol. So this slow ionization take place, and it form a carbocation. Before that carbocation form, it will be involved a transition state. That transition state is here. This will be have a higher energy. And after this carbocation, next step, actually nucleophilic attack take place, and oxonium, it form an oxonium. Before that, there will be a transition state here. Then second intermediate, you know, finally it form a product through a transition state. So these are the, you know, energy profile diagram of SN1 reaction. So in summary, what is the difference between SN1 and SN2 process? And in SN1, bond breaking and bond formation is not concerted one. SN2, it is a concerted reaction. And SN1 unimolecular, and SN2 is bimolecular. And SN1 is a two-step mechanism, SN2 is having one step. And there is a carbocation intermediate involved in SN1. There is no intermediate in SN2, but there is a transition state. And here the racemization occurs in SN1. In SN2, Walden inversion takes place. That's all. Thank you for watching my video.